you yourself, you wouldn't buy your product anyway. Your relatives wouldn't buy it, but somehow you still think there's a customer out there who is stupid enough to buy your product.
To be successful, you have to have your heart in your business and your business in your heart. A quick quote for those of you planning to start your business and those of you already running one. Hello and welcome to The Business Show, where we share ideas that could help you revamp your business, share investment opportunities, plus possible market changes. My name is Viola. Here are the weekly highlights. Supermarket chain Carrefour set to take over 6 stores that are currently being operated by ShopRite. Minister of Finance directs URA to halt move to tax business community importing textiles. Kenyan youth utilizing TikTok to showcase talent and earn a living. UK inflation rate hit 3.2% in the year to August, the biggest increase since records began in 1997. And Apple iPhone 13 brings portrait mode for video. On the onset of COVID-19, no one imagined that businesses would be affected and those employed lose their jobs. This has in turn seen several people opt to start businesses to stay employed and also earn a living. But with businesses collapsing day in and day out, tonight we tell you the do's and don'ts of operating a business, this and more, in Views from the Top.
No, I think before people use their savings to start a business, they need to be very careful. This is a very difficult business environment. Remember, many businesses are closing now because there's hardly any demand. Okay, so because you've lost your job, it doesn't mean things are any better out here. So you have to be very careful what you're starting and what the opportunities are. Some sectors have opportunities, some sectors don't. So it really depends on what you want to do and whether you as a person, because yes, the sector may have opportunity, but you as an individual are extremely unprepared. Okay. Then you may be very, very prepared in the wrong sector. So how do you balance those two things to ensure that you move in at the right time? So people shouldn't assume that just because I've left my job, things have to be better. The other side, I've been seeing stories that are saying people are making money in business. No, the actual picture is a bit different. Yes, some people are succeeding, but some people are also not succeeding. Then you also need time. You can't start a business and then you start making money. So it means even when you're saying I want to start a business, it should not be for survival. You should have sorted out the survival bit and you should assume that this business might take between 5 to 6 years before it picks up. So the motivation is also very critical. So if you go in thinking, oh, I'm going to start a business, going to start paying my bills. So basically you're trying to create an income stream to replace what you've lost. That may not really work. First of all, I'll start by talking to those who are employed. If you're still employed, please handle your job with care, because jobs right now are very scarce and it's not as rosy as you might think out here. For those who have been forced into starting a business because there are limited options, my view is that make sure you study, as I said, the sector very well. If you have any knowledge gaps or any experience gaps, try to fill them. Either by you acquiring that skill or by bringing someone who is knowledgeable in that sector. Secondly, you yourself, you must have a backup for money to take you, to make you survive as you, because the business is only going to bring that money soon. So make sure you have your own money and then you have money for the business. Put aside. The other thing is that do not invest large sums of money now. It's a very volatile period. You rather invest little and lose little than invest much and lose much. The other tip is, please don't take out a loan. This is a very bad time to take out a loan, except if you're very, very, very sure that money is going to come. Even if you got a government contract, there's no guarantee that government will pay you in time. So that's why right now is a very bad time to take out a loan facility. First of all, try to meet a genuine need in the market. No, some people assume market needs. You sit there, you say, I think this is what people want. You yourself, you wouldn't buy your product anyway. Your relatives wouldn't buy it, but somehow you still think there's a customer out there who is stupid enough to buy your product. So it's very, very important that whatever you put on the market meets an actual need. Secondly, try to look at what is already there. You know, we all think we are very smart. You think, oh, I've come up with this great idea. No one has ever thought about it. Well, most things have been thought about by someone. So try to study from people who have been in the space. What has worked, what hasn't worked. Talk to the clients. What do they like about the existing products? What don't they like about the existing products? Don't get so stuck about something called their business plan. It's very good, but sometimes it's time wasting. The issue is the principle. Make sure you understand clearly in your head what you're trying to do. You understand the market, you've spoken to people, and there's a clear market opportunity. Then you move. As I said, start small. You know, all of us are ambitious. We must start big. There's no business that starts big, so start small. Make whatever mistakes you make, and then pick yourself up and build your business. So don't be extremely ambitious, otherwise you'll get frustrated. When you've started, normally when you start a business, you don't have a marketing budget. So you're going to get most of your clients through referrals. Now, I'm talking about either a product or a service, whatever you choose to do. Most people walk in through referrals. So it means that there are few people that come in, they should live extremely satisfied. They should feel happy about the product that they receive from you. And they need to give you that feedback. Right now, because of the trend around digitalization, people give reviews about the service that you offer. Make sure that your review online is very good. The other issue is that please have an online presence. So we're talking about physical networking, the contacts that you already know. We're also talking about the online networking, because that's also a very good resource. The people you've met online, make sure that you give them a good impression, you're engaging, you explain properly what your product is, and make sure you have a good online presence. These are very cheap things, but they can make a difference with regard to whether your business succeeds or fails. Must be trustworthy as a vendor online. If you describe a product online, that's what you should deliver. Don't deliver a fake one, because, well, that person won't see me and so on. No. That they'll give you a bad review online, and then it will do more harm than good. So you shouldn't compromise your level of service just because you've not seen that person physically. And then try to also diversify the kind of payment options you accept. It's mobile money, if it's this, if it's that. Look at different options, online banking, whatever. Try to make sure that when someone contacts you, they are not put off because you don't accept one payment method or the other. Yes. think you need necessarily to separate the family. Because now you see with our Indian friends, they have to involve their family, but their business is our platform. So I think involving the family is not necessarily a bad thing. The issue is what they do in their business and what role they play. You must make the family subordinate to professionals until such a time when you're ready to hand over the business to them. Unfortunately for us, people, your family members, enter the business and treat it as a family affair. And that's when problems arise. But if you're able to create sufficient boundaries, I think it's actually healthy to have family in the business if you want it to survive beyond a generation. For the entrepreneurs, I want to say keep going. Times are difficult. As a Federation of SMEs, we are engaged at different levels trying to ensure that the conditions in which you operate are conducive. And we are happy that government has been very engaging and has listened. And together, we've been able to change very many things.
Clearly stated for you. As a startup, always remember you don't have to find a customer for your product, but rather a product for your customer. Time now for a quick break. You're watching The Business Show.